Bad Habits, Bad Health of the Presidents of the United States. Being power people does not mean that they know how to take good care of their health. Here are some extremely harmful habits of the 10 U.S. presidents. 1. Donald Trump. The 45th president of the United States is not afraid to say he is a fast food lover. On Trump's personal page, it's not hard to find photos of him enjoying KFC or McDonald's sandwich. He also seems to be a fan of soda when this drink usually appears on the desk. When Donald Trump came to take over the White House on behalf of Barack Obama, chefs were told that the almonds would be replaced with fries during the New England presidential dinner. According to nutrition experts, one piece of fried chicken contains about 390 calories and 21 grams of fat. Add two biscuits and one bag of chips to 850 calories, along with 41 grams of fat, 18 grams of saturated fat, and 71 grams of carbohydrates. Obviously, this is a diet that experts recommend to avoid to be able to protect health. 2. Barack Obama. Although First Lady Michelle Obama promotes healthy diets and exercise, President Barack Obama has harmed his health since smoking habits. Obama acknowledged nicotine addiction from late adolescence. Prior to running for the presidency in 2007, he was asked by his wife to quit smoking but still took drugs from his assistant. By the end of 2009, the 44th president of the United States has decided chewing gum nicotine all the time at the White House was his way of restraining his cravings. 3. George W. Bush. Former wife Laura Bush revealed in an interview in 2010 that her husband was a heavy drinker at a young age. But he ended up with a very bad habit after his 40th birthday, before he took office in 2000. Not only did the hepatitis killer, 200 calories a day makes you gain weight. 4. Bill Clinton. Although later, former President Bill Clinton made a healthier lifestyle with a vegetarian diet, but bad eating habits in the past, before being elected, were more or less devastating to his health. A 1992 New York Times article described in detail Bill Clinton's hobbies with fatty foods in the restaurant, especially barbecue, in addition to cheese, chicken, waffles. At that time, Hillary Clinton was on her side encouraging her husband to give up bad habits, hard work to help him reduce about 13 kilograms before taking office in 1993. 5. Ronald Reagan. In addition to smoking addiction, the 40th president of the United States is also a fan of outdoor activities. Growing up in California, every day Reagan spends most of his time outside for sports, fun, and work, without any protection from the sun. So, it is not surprising that he has basal cell carcinoma. The disease usually develops on sun exposure. 6. Gerald Ford. President Gerald Ford is famous for always having pipe tobacco on his lips. All reports of smoking and his health were not disclosed until 1964, 10 years before Ford took office. According to reports, the 38th president smoked up to 8 cigarettes a day. This habit has severely affected his lungs and overall health. The biggest health risks associated with smoking are lung, throat, and oral cancer. In addition, this is also the cause of cardiovascular disease, including heart attack and stroke. 7. William Howard Taft. William Howard Taft ate a lot of meals a day, including a 350-gram steak with 920 calories and 65 grams of fat without the added butter. Meanwhile, the American Heart Association recommends meat intake in the diet should only stop at 170 grams. No wonder his weight has reached 150 kilograms at times. 8. Grover Cleveland. The 22nd and 24th U.S. president also struggled with the problem of being overweight throughout their lives. In addition to eating too much, hate exercise, he is also a heavy drinker. When trying to drink alcohol, he also used up to 4 glasses of beer and wine each day. With a weight of 113 kilograms, Grover Cleveland was the second heavyweight in the United States, after William Howard Taft. 9. Martin Van Buren. Alcohol seems to be a popular hobby in American presidents. Martin Van Buren drank so much whiskey that he was nicknamed Blue Whiskey Van. This is thought to be the cause of gout and subsequent heart problems. The Food and Drug Administration recommends women drink only one serving of whiskey per day and men should limit it to 2 glasses a day. 10. John Adams. He usually starts a new day with hard cider, the fermented wine from the main ingredient is apples. According to health experts, drinking alcohol affects health, and drinking in the morning can also make you a slave to alcohol. That means you can go to the threshold that you cannot start a day without alcohol.